Today is the fifth annual New Generation Latino Consortium Conference. Can you talk about some of the topics that are being discussed or were discussed?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, it's the fifth annual, if I'm not mistaken, and Mun2's pretty much was a huge partner and presented the conference, and in terms of like content and in terms of bringing in all these expert panelists to kind of talk about like what it is to be part of this new media, advertising, entertainment, film, music, Latino world.
Can you describe what New Generation Latino means? Who are you talking about?
Absolutely. The New Generation Latino is a huge chunk of the population nowadays. As we know, the census numbers came in. The largest minority in this country is the Latino community, and about 60% of that community is youth. So when we're talking about this new generation, it's predominantly Mexican Americans, Cuban Americans, Puerto Rican Americans, Salvadoran Americans that live in this duality, that are still speaking Spanish and English, doing it Spanglish, are very bilingual, are going to American schools, public schools for the most part, enjoy Spanish music, listen to Drake, Lady Gaga, and that's why it becomes so much more of like this dynamic world, because it's kind of like a new little niche in the Latino community that we can't really cater to them in terms of content and in terms of ads the way we cater to this older idea that we had of the Latino community.
This I guess portion of the population is really growing. How do you think that it will affect the election this year, the 2012 election?
Oh, it's going to be one of the, I think, if not the most pivotal like topic. And just in terms of, I'm sure everybody knows the Time magazine cover. It's pretty much the first cover that focuses on the elections and who's going to be deciding the elections this year. And Time magazine calls it like, the new generation of Latinos will be deciding and choosing who the next president will be because of the numbers. Mun2's has been doing this for such a long time. Like we're waiting for like the moment for people to realize, yo, you know, like there's this new generation of young kids out there that are speaking English, that are speaking Spanish, that want to get content in both languages, that live this duality, that belong to the American society as much as they do, you know, belong to their family's culture. So I think we were just waiting for this moment to just really, for people to really be like, oh my gosh. So, I mean, there is this little niche, there is this community.